So hi guys, my name is Nachiketa. Welcome back to another video. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can build this image classification web application. Let me show you how this basically works. So basically, I've trained a deep learning model that recognizes flowers. So there are basically five categories of flowers. Let's say I'm selecting any particular category, like let's say daisy. I click on the image, I submit it, and I'll get an output prediction of what is the likelihood of it belonging to a particular class. Right now it's pretty confident that it's a daisy, which is correct, and you can upload any image and it works like this, right? Sometimes it might not give a very good accuracy, but for most of the times it really does. So this is a sunflower. I pick an image and I get sunflower as a prediction. So this is the model that we're going to be building. I've previously made videos on the same, on building deep learning applications. I've made a flower classification a tutorial as well, but that was built using Streamlit for the web application. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how we can do this using the Gradio library. Now it's very, very simple. So without wasting any time, let's get started. Now I'm not going to focus a lot on the deep learning model that I've built, because you might be using some other deep learning model, right? So we're just going to focus on how we can integrate it and how the general flow is. So this is how the flow basically works, and then I'll start explaining the code. You have to first train a deep learning model, then you have to define a function that will take an input image and give the input image to the deep learning model and get a prediction. Lastly, you have to call the Gradio class that simply takes three input: the function that is making the prediction and accepts one input from the web application, and third argument would be how you want to send out the output. So we start with the deep learning model, then we'll define the function, then I'll show you how to integrate that in Gradio, right? So first of all, we start by installing Gradio library using pip install command. I import the particular libraries. These are some libraries that I'm going to be using. We'll get to them when we get to that part in the code. So this is the part where I'm importing the data set. The data set of flowers that I'm using has been publicly made available by TensorFlow. I'll leave this notebook as well in the description. Also, you can just simply search TensorFlow image classification problem. This is where I'm going to get the data set. So we basically get the data set from this particular URL, and we get the flower photos file, and you can see it says downloading the data set. Now, just to show how a particular image could look like, in the directory we take out all the images in the rows category, and we print the first one by using the index as 0, and this is how a particular rows image looks like. Over here, we are simply generating training and validation data. We specify the image height and width, which is 180 x 180. Make sure that you have specified the correct dimension for your image. And this is where we're generating data set. We are splitting 80% of the data into training set, 20% as validation, and specifying the image, image dimension and batch size. It tells you that out of 3,675, 2,936 have been reserved for training. Similarly, we're doing the same to reserve 20% of the data set as the validation part. So you're going to train the model on the testing set, and with each epoch, it's going to test the model on the validation part. So basically, we can see what the class names are in the training set by using this line, and we can see there are five classes: daisy, dandelion, roses, sunflowers, and tulips. This could be anything for your case. And over here, we're just using matplotlib, and we're creating a figure size of 10 cross 10. And basically plotting 9 sample images in the training data set. So this is how an image looks like. You can see it with the corresponding labels. Again, I'm skimming fast through the code because everyone will be using different deep learning models, but the general flow is going to remain the same. And here is the part where we actually train the deep learning model. We have 5 classes, and basically we're using 3 convolution neural networks followed by a max pooling layer each. And last layer over here uses a softmax for classification. So make sure you know the correct number of classes for whatever problem you're solving. Let's say you have 8 classes, you have to make that change over here. And for compiling the model, I'm using Adam Optimizer and sparse categorical cross entropy. I'm basically training the model for 10 epochs. Up till over here, your code is gonna be exactly the same, right? Just the data set is gonna differ, the dimensions of the data is gonna differ. And you have to see how much accuracy your model is getting by the end of 10 epochs. Based on that, you can vary the number of epochs as well. So that is for the deep learning part. Now we get to actually implementing that on the web application. Again, when you accept an image, we have to reshape that into 4 dimensions, right? Because the model is not trained on one three-dimensional image, it's trained on multiple three-dimensional image. So in the time of predictions as well, you have to make sure you give the image an extra dimension, right? So this is basically four dimension, not 3D. And this line over here is not needed. Let me just run this part again. Okay, so now we make a prediction on the model, and what we are returning over here is a dictionary. So basically what happens is, right, we don't want just the output prediction. We want to display a dictionary with each class and its corresponding probability. So I'm for basically for I in range 5, since there are 5 classes, I'm printing each element in the class name corresponding to its actual prediction, and I'm returning this dictionary. So let me run this now. And here is where I'm defining the input and output. Again, you can watch this in the Gradio documentation as well. This is how you define an input basically for accepting images. There are three forms of accepting an image. You can basically get it through webcam, you can get it through a sketchpad where you sketch it on the screen, or you can upload an image, right? So here I'm defining that the shape is equal to 180 cross 180. So whatever image it gets, it will convert that into this dimension. And when I say outputs.label num top classes equal to 5, this will basically print the confidence probability for the top 5 classes. And when I'm now, I just have to call the interface class in Gradio, and I have to provide the three things, as I said, that we are going to use the predict image function. The input is going to be image that we have defined, output is going to be label. And when I write launch debug is equal to true, basically means that whenever an error comes up, I can view that in my Google Colab console. So let me just run this again, and this will give you an interface in Google Colab itself, also give you an external link. And in the next video, I'll show you how to host that onto cloud as well, but that is normally paid. I think it's $7 per month. So as you can see, this link will expire in 24 hours, just mentioned over here. And when I click on the link, this web app opens up. So I simply go to my flower photos. You have to download this again by going through a link. I can click on any image. So let's say again, I go to daisies. This one I think should be harder to classify because there's a bee sitting on top. There's an error. And the error says 3D is not defined, so probably a spelling mistake. And okay, so let me just change that. So I'll run this again, and now it should work. So again, I can go to any category. So this time I'm going to Daisy, and I click on an image, I upload that. So it will make correct predictions for most. Let's say I take a confusing one, though, let's say with a bee sitting on top, might be a wrong prediction. So now it's less confident that's Daisy, right? That's how it works. And you can even edit the image in Gradio itself. If you want to crop it, there's some part you want to remove, you can do that as well. So this is how it works. And that was it for, this tutorial. You can even train natural language processing models in Gradio and even deploy that onto cloud. Maybe I'll cover that in my future videos. And if you did like it, do like this video and subscribe to this channel, and see you in the next video.